Hi friends. Today's story is Love Monster by Rachel Bright. Today we're going to go on a journey to find our monster, a friend who would love him. Love a monster. This is a monster. Hello, monster. I think you'll agree he's a little bit funny looking, to say the least. Doesn't look like any of my friends. He lives in a world of cute, fluffy things. A fissile pile of extreme cuteness. Look at all those cute animals. Which makes being funny looking pretty hard. You might have noticed that everybody loves kittens and puppies and bunnies. You know, cute, fluffy things. But nobody loves a slightly hairy, I suppose a bit googly-eyed monster. Poor monster. This might be enough to make a monster feel, well, a bit down in the dumps. But not being the moping around sort. He decided to set out and look for someone who'd love him just the way he was. So he's gonna search for someone who's gonna love him like the monster he is. He looked high, look up high. He looked low, look down low. He looked middle-ish, right in the middle. He looked inside and outside. More than once, he thought that maybe, just maybe, he'd found what he was looking for. But as it turned out, things were never quite as they seemed. Yes, it would be fair to say that his search did not go well. And then it didn't go well some more. Poor monster. I hope he finds someone soon. Do you think he'll find someone? Let's find out. It didn't go well for such a long time. In fact, that it began to get dark and scary. And, well, not very nice. So, the monster, having lost all of his oomph, decided it was time to give up and go home. It's gonna get on the bus and go home. But, in the blink of a googly eye, everything changed. You see, sometimes when you least expect it, love finds you. The end. Thanks for joining me, friends, for our story, Love Monster.